Good morning, Standard 4C. How are you? Now, children, I think all of you are fine. So, let us start today's class with Gayatri Mantra. All of you, close your eyes, join your hands, and start to chant Gayatri Mantra. Om Bhur Bhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Vargo Devasya Dhimahi धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं वर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं वर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। With this beautiful mantra, Gayatri Mantra, we will start our session. Come, children, come with me. I will teach you noun today. Today, I will teach you noun, the naming words. You have learned in your previous class what are naming words. Now, today I am going to start. So, now children, look at this. What is this? Flower, leaf, vase. See, this is a tortoise. See, tortoise. This is an elephant. Engine, number 9. This is engine. This is a car. See, this is a tortoise. And what is this? This is an elephant. What is this? This is a temple. What is this? This is a bear. And what is this? This is a thread. And what is this? This is a bottle. What is this? This is a bed. What is that? That is window. What is this? This is a cupboard. What is this? This is a carpet. What is that? That is an almirah. What is on the almirah? That is vase, white flowers. That is photo frame. That is also photo frame. This is a wall. This is door. That is switchboard. That is fan. So, my dear children, so all these things are, this is a stool, this is a laptop, that is mouse. See that books are there, so many things, that is idols, that small idols are there, see, idols, see, that is a temple, that is a temple. So, all lots of things, this is a stool, this is a laptop. So, children, all these things are naming words. All these things are naming words. So, what are naming words? So, now, today, I am going to teach you naming words. Naming words. All these are the naming words. So, what are the naming words? The name of a person, place, the name of these things. All these things. See, lots of things are there. So, the name of all this is bed, these are clothes, that is window, that is photo frame, that is almirah, that is photo frame, that is flowers. So, all these, the name of all those things are called naming words. So, these are called naming words. Now, children, today, let us start with page number 1. This is page number 1. Okay. So this is page number 1. So here the today's topic is naming word. We will start worksheet number 1. Around the house. So all of you see, this is a house. So in the house, so many things are there. See, so many things are there. There is a carpet and so many things are there. So bed, clothes, window. So many things are there in this room. See, and so similarly, so look at the words given below. Help Neeti to arrange these things in their proper rooms in the given network. And also add one more object in each room. So there are different types of rooms are there. This is a bedroom. Okay, in a house there are different kinds of room. That is bedroom, sitting room. In a house that is kitchen, that is bathroom, that is bedroom. So many types of rooms are there in a house. So there are, these are the things that I am going to read. I am going to show you. This is saucepan, this carpet, bed sheet, dressing table, shower, kettle, stove, center table, sofa, wardrobe, wash basin, towel. So all these things you have to arrange all these things in a proper room. Okay. So saucepan, where we used to find saucepan? Saucepan we find in kitchen. So right here in the kitchen, this is kitchen section. So right here, saucepan in this place, in the just beside this kitchen, near this kitchen. Okay. Next is carpet. Where we used to see carpet? Carpet is in the sitting room. Carpet is in the sitting room. This is sitting room. So carpet is always in the sitting room. Now next come bed sheet. Bed sheet, where we get bed sheet? We see bed sheet in the bedroom. So write down, just see, just near bedroom you will have to write bed sheet. Okay. Now next is dressing table. Dressing table, where we used to see? We see dressing table in the bedroom. In the bedroom you will have to write dressing table. We see dressing table in the bedroom. Now come to shower. Where we used to see shower? Shower we used to see in bathroom. In the bathroom you have to write shower. And then next is kettle. Where do we see kettle? Kettle we see in the kitchen. So in the kitchen section you have to write kettle. Now come to stove. Stove also we used to see in kitchen. So you have to write in kitchen section. This is kitchen section. Now come to center table. Center table is always in where? Center table is in the sitting room, in the drawing room. So we have to write, you have to write center table in the sitting room. Now come to sofa. Sofa is also in the sitting room. You have to write here in the sitting room. Now it is wardrobe. I have shown you where is the, where do we see wardrobe? Wardrobe is always in the bed. Wardrobe is in the bedroom. So in the bedroom you have to write wardrobe. Now wash basin. Wash basin is always in the bathroom. In the bathroom you have to write wash basin. And towel. Where we used to keep towel? Towel we used to keep in bathroom. Okay. And next one thing, extra thing you have to write. In the sitting room we used to keep television. In kitchen we used to keep utensils. In bedroom we used to keep bed. In bathroom we used to keep bucket. So in this way, this is your C work. It's worksheet number 1 you have to do in this book. This is your C work. So put, write down C work here. Here you will have to write down C work. You will write here C work and you will put today's date 24/21. So this is today's C work. Now let us come to, this is today's C work. See, unit 1, page number 1, around the house. Now let us come to next. Next is all the words that you have filled in this name of the things. All these words that you have filled in this thing, these are the name of the things. All these are common. These are common. Bathroom is common noun. all these words are called common noun. So what are the common noun? Common noun are the words which are used as a common. So all these words that is used as a common noun, commonly used, that is nouns are called common noun. Okay children, so what are the common noun? The common noun is used for the group of words which belong to same category. The word which belongs to the same category, that is common noun. For example, girl. Girl is applicable boy. Boy is applicable for all the boys. Here, for whole category of boys. Okay, that is called the common noun. The words that you have filled are the name of the things. So, my dear children, a common noun is a word which is used to name a general thing. Example, water, dog, cat, animal, bird. They do not start with capital letter. A common noun is a word which is used to name a general thing. Example, water, dog, sofa, room, bed. They do not start with capital letter. The common noun does not start with capital letter. So here all of you see that all the words that you have filled are, these are naming words and these all are common noun. Okay, now let us tingle your mind. In which room do you read normally, listen to music? You listen to music generally in drawing room. And sleep? Bedroom. Watch TV? Drawing room. Take dinner? Dining room. Spend free time? Drawing room. Feel relaxed? Bedroom. Study? Study room. Now hey children, see, come to worksheet number 2. Guess who these people are. The dash loves his camera. Who loves his camera? Photographer. And this photographer is a common noun. I-P-H-O-T-O-G-R-A-P-H-E-R. So fill in the blanks for this. Some letters are missing. You will have to write with pencil. The photographer loves his camera. Now number 2. I teach in a school. I am a teacher. T-E-A-C-H-E-R. Teacher. Teacher is a common noun. Now 3rd, I fight for my country. I am a soldier. S-O-L-D-I-E-R. Soldier. Soldier is a common noun. Now 4th one, I sell fruits in the market. I am a fruit seller. This fruit seller is a common noun. Himanshu repairs cars and truck. He earns in living as a mechanic. M-E-C-H-A-N-I-C, mechanic. So mechanic is a common noun. So all these things, photographer, teacher, soldier, fruit seller, mechanic, these are general words. So these are belongs to photographer, means the all photographers. So all these words are common noun. So this is also your C work, today's C work. Okay children, now let us come to next worksheet number 3. This is a quiz time. So you have to give the correct answer. Who is popularly known as Master Blaster? Do you know who is the Master Blaster? Oh, it's Sachin Tendulkar is the Master Blaster. Okay children, who is the Master Blaster? Sachin Tendulkar is the Master Blaster. Which country is famous for noodles? China. Well, very nice. Which country is famous for noodles? China. Which country hosted the 2012 Olympic Games? Which country? Tell me. London. L-O-N-D-O-N, London. Which is the highest mountain peak in the world? Mount Everest. Who is the Prime Minister of our country? Narendra Modi. So these are the specific name. These are the special names. And these, Sachin Tendulkar, China, London, Mount Everest, and Narendra Modi. These are, you have written the special name of the people. Sachin Tendulkar is the special name of a batsman. China is the name of the country. London is the name of the country. Mount Everest is the name of the mountain. And Narendra Modi is the name of a prime minister. So these things are the special names for people, place and thing. And these special names are called proper noun. What are the proper noun? The special names for people, place and things are called proper noun. So now let us see. Proper noun, special name of a person, place or thing is proper noun. And proper noun is always written with, start with capital letter. It always starts with capital letter. So, special name of a person, place or thing is proper noun. It always starts with capital letter. We write proper noun. The first letter of the proper noun is always written with the capital letter. Now let us do the difference. This is proper noun. Proper noun. And it is common noun. Common noun is the name of the general thing. So for example, general thing is place. Okay. Like it is the name of the house. House is the common noun. The name of the house, Galaxy Green. Galaxy Green. It is the name. It is the special name of the house. Galaxy Green. It is the common name. House. Now next is girl. Sita. So the special name of the girl. It is a proper noun. And girl is a common noun. Now let us come to next. Common noun. Mountain. The proper noun, Mount Everest. Mount Everest. So this is the proper noun and this is the common noun. Person. Man. Ram. So this is, man is a common noun and Ram is a proper noun. And proper noun always starts with capital letter and it is not necessary. Common name can be written in the small letter also. Okay children, now let us move to the fun time. So here all of you see. So turning the reading passage of True Friends, Unit Sports of My English Reader, get into groups of four and picking out the naming words from the story and write under the following headings. So you have to play game. This is your homework. People, place and things. You have to find out this name, naming words from this chapter two time, True Friends. This is your today's worksheet number 3 is your homework. This is your homework of 28th April. Okay, so you have to sort out the name of the people, place and thing from chapter True Friends. Okay children, so come to worksheet number 4. So here in worksheet number 4, we will study the collective noun, the collection of the person and thing. Collection, for example, rose. So collection of roses, that is bouquet. The collection of these flowers is called bouquet. This is a pearls. The collection of pearls is a string of pearls. This is the key. So group of collection of key is called a bunch of key. So all these are like bouquet, string, bunch. These are also naming word. Bouquet, string and bunch, these are also naming word. So when the noun stands for the collection of the people and thing, it is called collective noun. All these are collective nouns. All these are collective noun. So here all of you see some words are there. Flock, army, fleet. It stands for flocks of sheep. Bhedo ka jund. Army. Army is the collection of soldiers. Soldiers. Saniko ke jund. Fleet. Fleet is the meaning of collection of ships. Ship means jahaj. Jahajo ke jo dher hote hain, unhe fleet kehte hain. Fleet means the collection of ships. Okay. Now come to the dictation test. Worksheet number 5. This is also your homework. In worksheet number 5, given below are some spelled collective noun. Replace one letter in each noun to get the correct spelling. So wrong spelling is there. One is there done for you. Have you ever heard the parliament of owls, the knot of toads? These are collective noun. Parliament, group of owls are called parliament. Knot of toads, group of toads are called knot of toad. A rookery of penguins, a gaggle of geese. So here the spelling, wrong spelling is there written for this collective noun. A block of sheep, it is flock of sheep. A fleet of ships, it is fleet of ship. F-L-E-E-T, fleet. Fleet of ships, it is F-L-E-E-T, fleet of ships. A munch of grapes, what it will be? It will be bunch of grapes. B U N C H. A sack of park, a pack of card. A drone of bees, a swarm of bees. S W A R M. A swarm of bees. A bird of elephant, a herd of elephant. H E R D. Herd of elephant. A choir of singers, a choir of singers. C H O I R. So again I am repeating, a block of sheep, it is flock. A fleet of sheep, it is fleet. A munch of grapes, it's bunch. A sack of card, it is pack. P-A-C-K. A swarm of sheep, it's a swarm. Bird of elephants, herd. A choir of singers, choir. So all these are collective nouns. Okay. So children, you have to learn also these collective nouns, the spellings of these collective nouns. So I will take your spelling test. Okay, all these are collective nouns. So you have to do it. Okay children, so now you have learned proper noun, common noun and collective noun. So you have to learn the definitions of proper noun, common noun and collective noun with examples. In the next class, I will tell you about the material noun, okay, and some more things about the common noun and proper noun and collective noun. So we will meet again in the next class. In the next class I will tell you some more worksheets regarding this unit number 1. So we will meet again. Sayonara. Bye.